The Steve Biko Foundation is a community development organization that was established in 1998, and it was interesting the way that we came about. In 1997, on the occasion of the 20th anniversary commemoration of Biko's death, a number of stakeholders had come together, the Biko family, political parties, government, people like Richard Branson, Stokely Carmichael, were going to be there to participate in this anniversary, and so they knew that there'd be a lot of interest, but what they didn't anticipate was that 20,000 people would show up on the streets of East London on a Friday morning to pay homage to Biko. And from there, our CEO, Kosinati, and others began thinking about how could they harness this energy around Biko's legacy into a sustainable way to facilitate community development. And out of that, the foundation was born. We do work in three major areas of the foundation. The first is international dialogue. The second is leadership development. And with our leadership development portfolio, we focus on arts and culture, economic justice, education, community health, as well as sports development. And then, of course, we have a relatively new program at the foundation, research, policy, and publications. And basically, in terms of all of our work, what we try to do is to bring people together with policy to really serve at that intersection and to help people take advantage of the opportunities that the new South Africa has offered. And so we're quite pleased to be here partnering with YFM this evening and for the rest of this year. We think dialogues of this nature are very important to begin to get people to think about these issues, to talk to one another, and to hopefully come up with active solutions. So we look forward to seeing how the rest of this unfolds and to continuing to share the legacy with our colleagues here at the radio station.
It raises questions which I think needed to be addressed tonight, like structural injustice. I think it's an abomination, to be honest, to talk about Biko without analyzing the structural injustices that face our society. So the book would be a lot more militant. But then again, I am a young student, so I can't get away from that perspective.